Hello, I'm Andrew. I'm on the gate 18, D18 in Stockholm, Amsterdam. And we're going to Izmir. The flight is about 3 hours. And this is, I think, look at this. This is our airplane. It's Arkefly. It's one of the best Dutch fly company. And okay. I'll be back when I am in the plane, and I hope I have a seat near the windows, so I can look outside, a little bit filming. We are now in Turkey, and I have bus number 3. Bus number 3 goes to Kusadasi. Yeah? And as you can see, we picked out the right day, because in Holland it's storming, it's raining, and here the sun is shining. I just can take everything out and walk in my swimming trousers in the bus because it's nice weather. Okay, I will be back when I come back in the hotel. I'll show you the hotel, and it's called Dirici. I just got the papers from my host over there, and okay, and I wait for the bus driver. He's finished driving us to that nice hotel.
I'm sitting in the bus, and as you can see, there's the airport, Izmir. Well, we wait for the bus driver to bring us to our hotel, and I believe it will take us 90 minutes to arrive in our hotel. And it's a nice sunny day, look at that. Blue sky, unbelievable. We left Amsterdam with rain, and there was a storm coming, and now we are in Turkey, Izmir. The sun is shining.
So I arrived in the hotel, and later I will show you the outside of the hotel. And the first thing I noticed was that the television was on a Dutch station, very nice from this hotel. And I have free Wi-Fi, so that's also nice. So it is 10 o'clock in the morning, 5 hours my plane left Schiphol, Amsterdam to Izmir, Turkey, and now I am in the hotel. So in 5 hours I am in my hotel in Turkey. The weather is beautiful, I think it's about 23, 24 degrees today. And well, the weather forecast is not that good. The rest of the week is cloudy, maybe rainy, and that's not good. That's not a good sign. But yeah, you never know. I hope for miracles so that my week in Turkey, Izmir or Kusadasi, this is Kusadasi, will be a very pleasant one. The reason for my holiday is a double one. First of all, I came here for the sun, a little bit sun, a little bit beach, I hope, yes. And the most important thing is I came for my dentist. It's the first time I will do a dent job, you know, in Turkey. My brother was here last year and he was very, very, very satisfied. Well, the price of the dentist is here very cheap. I will, in the end of the movie, you will see what I do, how much I paid for my dentist. I will show you the my balcony, the outside of my view of my balcony.
This is the view, beautiful. There's the harbor. Let me zoom in. Beautiful view. Very nice boulevard. And my dentist is that direction. Yes, about 800 meters walking. And well, this is beautiful, look at this. Blue sea, blue sky, and I hope my 8 days in Kusadasi will have the same weather as today. But I don't think the weather will stay like this, because look at this. Well, this place, the name is Kusadasi, and normally they are living here 95,000 people. Yes, so almost 100,000 people. And in summer, this place have 1 million people. So this is how Kusadasi is. So this is how my hotel is looking. And that's a big room. And for the money I pay, it is terrific. I have even nice television with Dutch TV. I came in this room and they put Dutch TV on it. Unbelievable. And let me show you my bathroom. This is my bathroom. Okay. I have everything clean. And you even have a bath. Beautiful, look at this. And that all for 380 euros. Inclusive breakfast and dinner. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. This is a big joke. I'm going to change myself now. Put some nice clothes on. Maybe a short pants. And I'm going a little bit outside walking to see what this little town have to offer. And I will be back with more info about this city. So at this place I'm gonna eat my first dinner in Kusadasi. I will tell you if the dinner is a good one. The place is named Korbatsi 3. I drink some Fanta, you see. Nice Turkish Fanta. I'm near the beach, you see. It's a marvelous place to sit. And very busy, lot of traffic. This is my dinner. Unbelievable, look at this, this thing is big. Wow. Fanta. Yeah, man. Well, as you can see, back of me, this big ship is there. And beautiful place. And well, the weather is blue sky, nice sun. And I'm enjoying this place, And really, it's my first day here, but the place looks fantastic. Look at this. Beautiful. So from here you can see my hotel room, look at this. I think this is my hotel room. Ah, I forget to close the balcony door. So, good that I filmed this, and this is my hotel. Hotel De Ricci. You can read it here. It's the outside. And I see some fishermen over there. I'm gonna see what they're catching. And here there are some fishermen, and I want to see what they catch. How big fish. This is the champion from Kusadasi, fisherman, and but I don't see any fish, no fish. Look at this beautiful place. Well, this is his first catch. Look at this. He have two. Unbelievable, look at this. But they are not big. small.
For big fish.
What's this? What's this? This is a very strange fish. Look at this. It is looking like eel.
Oh, he's gonna. I don't know how to jump here. He would like to use for big fish.
Beautiful fish.
Takıyor, bırakıyor. Zargana. Zargana, zargana takıyor.
Look, nice fish.
No, 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 no.
Ah, oh, grande, grande. I think he have a big one. I'm not sure, but well, I saw this stick moving from him half a meter up and down. So we have it have to be a big one. I want to see what is coming out of the water.
I have half an hour to watch this.
Oh yeah, that's a big one. Yeah. Yeah. Oh my God. I have to stand up. I'm gonna stand up because I'm sitting down a rock. And because this is a big one. I'm waiting for this for 2 hours now. And watch this. Watch this guy, what he's taking out of the water. Unbelievable. I want to see this. Unbelievable. I'm very curious. We are in Kusadasi, in front of my hotel. And I film this guy catching, I hope, a monstrous fish. Good for 7 days meal, food. I don't know what he's doing, but he's a professional. He's a professional. Just following him. What's this? Unbelievable. We're on the beach. Look at this, look at this! Unbelievable! This is a big one!
Wow!
Oh! Ho, ho, ho. Oh, look at this, look at this! Unbelievable!
Sağ
ol. Sağ olasın. Ağzıma bu
koparır valla.
Koparır.
Şampiyon gibi, şampiyon.
Şampiyon, şampiyon. Well, this is something. My first day in Kusadasi, in front of my hotel. Look, my hotel is over here. What's my hotel? And this guy, and well, I talked with some guys over here, and they told me this guy is the meister, the best fisher from this part. So,
where is this guy, Mola?
Unbelievable. Look at this guy.
El heykeli, elin önündeyim. Amcamın bir tanesi, bir tane papara çekti.
Well. So, we now know that Kusadasi is not only good for dentists, sun, but also for fishing. If you come here to fish, you always catch a big one. And everybody wants to take pictures with the big fish. That's a nice fish. Well, I'm ending this nice afternoon here on the beach from Kusadasi in front of the Darici Hotel. And I'm so happy that I could film this catch, this big catch from the day. And well, maybe tomorrow I will film again and I come back to the same place and maybe again I will film a big catch.
Bedeninizde sağlığın, kalbinizde sevginin, çevrenizde huzurun ve işlerinizde başarının eksikliğini hissetmeyeceğiniz nice güzel günler, nice güzel geceler dileğiyle saygın kişiliğinizin önünde
from my hotel. I entered this restaurant and this music fills my ears, and you will enjoy this movie too, because listen to this. The first restaurant in 50 meters. Listen to this sound.
In the port side, and this is about 800 meters away from my hotel. And as you can see, this is the local restaurant, very nice. And what's more nicer, watch these houses built against the mountain. Unbelievable view. And what we see there is a sort of fort. Let me zoom in on this fort. This fortress, well, I don't know what it is. I don't know from which year it is, but when I come home, I will Google it up and I will inform you about this beautiful fort. These are the, well, the boats. I think they are fisher boats or tourist boats. I don't know. Well, watch this, watch this. I just go slowly, see how beautiful this thing is. And all these houses built against this mountain. Unbelievable. Very, very nice. This Kusadasi is not what I expected. I'm really positive, well, surprised. Just walking, very beautiful, and I'm walking closer to this fortress because I want to see this closer, you know. It looks so impressive, this thing, and I don't know what it is, but I'm sure when I came close there have to be some sign what tells me which or what fortress this is and from which year it is. Well, look at this boat. He's having some melons, very nice boat. Zoom out. Nice boat. I don't know what kind of boat it is, but it's a nice boat, old boat. I love old boats. And this guy is carrying melons. Beautiful boats, look at this. And the water is clean. And these are tourist boats you can eat. This is a restaurant. And as you can see here, a 1 hour tour, only 5 lira. Well, that's cheap. That's 2 euro. I think I'm gonna have a tour later on the day. Here again, 1 hour boat tour. Unbelievable. And these are nice, nice boats. They put some pirates on the entrance, as you can see. And this is nice. This is really nice. All these boats. And so cheap, five lire is about 2 euro, unbelievable. And for this 2 euro, you can have 1 hour boat trip. Well, in the Netherlands, we also have boat trips. But if you go on a boat trip for 1 hour, well, it will cost you at least 25 euro. And that's the difference. Well, I'm standing in front of the entrance from this fortress. And as you can see, and due to restoration, it is closed, okay? So we cannot go inside. But now we have, this sign tells you what it is. I think the building started in 1826 and it was ended in 1850. They built these fortresses in the 17th, 18th and 19th century to protect their cities against, well, other ships, enemy ships and well, this fortress is on. Look at this, look at this. I will show you how beautiful. I will zoom in on the other side. Beautiful. And I wanted to walk up that hill. That hill is very stiff, if you can see, and I wanted to come to the ladies' beach, and the ladies' beach is about, well, this guy told me it's about 1 hour walking, and I'm a little bit too tired to go up that hill, And I can't see the ladies' beach from here. That's the most popular beach from Usagasi. And next time I will take a bus. And this bus will bring me to the ladies' beach so I can show you where this thing is. Beautiful. Beautiful fortress. Look at this. Unbelievable. It looks very strong. So I'm standing in front of the fortress and this is the hotel where I'm staying, Hotel Berici. And I zoom back and you can see how far I am now. I walked all this distance. This is very far. Let me zoom in one more time. Watch this. Hotel Berici. The hotel I stay. And because Kusadasi is a very big place. Look at this. You have a better view now. And it doesn't end here. It doesn't end here. I showed you just now. And it doesn't end there. It goes all the way to the, well, to the left side from my hotel. But today I'm not gonna walk that distance. Maybe tomorrow I take the bus because it's too far away. 1 hour walking to the ladies' beach, the famous ladies' beach. I'm standing now in the middle of this shopping street. Very nice, look at this banana trees. And banana really grows in Kusadasi. Unbelievable, look at this. And well, this street, this shopping street ends directly on the beach, you can say, or the beach, the sea coast, because there is not a real beach on this part of Kusadasi. But believe me guys, I'm just one day in Kusadasi and I'm looking my eyes out because there's so much things. Everywhere you have nice restaurants, fresh orange juice. So it's my second day here in the afternoon. And as you can see, it's cloudy. The weather is changing. And I think the rest of the week, I'm not lucky it stay like this, okay? Maybe some rain will fall. And I'm back here to this place where these local fishermen, yesterday they catch a big one, and I'm back here just to see something else happening here. And well, as you can see, yesterday was so lucky they did catch some big fish. And maybe today, you're lucky again. And see some new action. Today I'm sitting here, second day in Kusadasi. I'm sitting with my two new friends. Yeah. And I'm explaining to them how internet is working. Hello. Okay? These guys live in Kusadasi. And they explained something from Kusadasi. Okay? Thank you. See you
later.
Well, as you can see, my third day, Kusadasi is a rainy day. I'm filming from my balcony. And on the back you heard this this sound coming from the mosque. It is raining and my whole day is spoiled because of this rain. There are some people still on the street. It's the end of the day, 6 o'clock in the evening, but as I speak the mosque is also shouting his tunes. I'm sitting on my bed now. I sound a little bit sleepy because I just wake up, and because there's really nothing to do when it's raining outside, especially if you brought the wrong shoes and you can't buy the good size. Yes, because I went shopping, yes, early this morning. Let me start with yesterday. What happened yesterday? I went with these three guys, I met these three guys, young guys. They are students, tourist students here in Kusadasi. Very nice guys, and we had much fun. And we went to this local internet cafe, and next to our table there were two young Turkish girls sitting, two nice girls, and they involved in our conversation. And she gave me a tip. I asked her where I can have nice fun in the evening, and she gave me a tip. She told me I have to go to the X Club. So I went walking to the X Club last night, and I had to pay entrance for the leader. This is about 15 euro. That's not much. and this was including a drink, a free drink. So I ordered a vodka tonic. Well, normally I never drink, but okay, I think I don't have to drive. I'm on a holiday. Let's take a vodka tonic. Next day, of course, I woke up very late, or too late for the breakfast, and I missed that breakfast. I woke up 11 o'clock in the morning, and breakfast is until 10. I took a bath, yes, and when I was finished, I went outside, and for the second time, because yesterday too, I tried to buy some shoes. I went to some shops. Yes, they had my size, but ugly, ugly shoes. And well, I like some stylish shoes, and they don't have many shoes in my size. Yes, I have size 45. I think that's a 10 and a half, 11 in America. And they don't have that size in Turkey. These shoes are very cheap. Cheap shoes, cheap clothes, everything is cheap. But I only needed some, because I only packed in my white shoes. And with these white shoes, these are handmade 200 euro shoes. You can't walk in the rain. You will spoil them in 30 minutes. You can throw them away. And I don't want to walk with these shoes in this rainy streets, because these streets, well, if you see how these streets are looking now, terrible. And that was my mistake. I have plenty shoes in my house, especially for this weather, but I only packed my white shoes, yes, because I didn't want to carry too much weight with me with my suitcase. So I only packed one pair of shoes, and that's stupid. Always pack a shoes for the rainy times. And let that be a lesson for you guys, because I made that mistake. Anyway, I'm sitting here with these white shoes, yes, handmade, expensive shoes, and I cannot walk outside, so I have to find tomorrow a pair of shoes, yes, shoes I can walk in the rain, because I don't want to spoil these shoes. And well, an umbrella is easy to buy. You can buy on every corner, you can buy an umbrella, but there also are the shoes. And it's 6 o'clock in the evening now. Now I'm going to take a hot bath.
Yeah. I have to fill this tube. Yes, like this. And the water pressure is very strong here. Unbelievable. First day, I put too much. Let me put some. Yeah, one more, okay. So I'm filling my bath now, because I take a nice bath. I will shave myself. I didn't shave myself today in the morning, so I will shave myself before I go into that bath. Go to the dinner from the hotel, and then I hope the rain is stopped, and I'm going to try to find my shoe size 45. Well, this was day 3 from my holiday. And tomorrow I come back, hopefully with some better news, some better adventures here in Kusadasi. As you can see, there are 2 cruise ships at the moment, and there's even a third one on the other side of the dock. And I'm in front of my hotel now. Here's my hotel, Hotel de Ritz. Yeah, and just in front I have this beautiful view. Let me zoom in on these cruise ships. Beautiful. Big cruise ship. And the third one is, as you can see, behind it. And I will walk this short distance. I was there 2 days ago, but there were no ships 2 days ago. I will walk this distance, and I come back when I'm closer to these ships, and to show you how these ships looks like, okay? Well, look at this big ship. Beautiful, Serenade of the Seas. And I don't know where the ship is coming from, but well, behind it you can see another ship. And all these tourists, all these vessel tourists, they visit Kusadasi, they buy their beautiful things, their carpets, their jewelry, their clothes, and they go back on their ships. And I don't know where they go from here. But there are even 2 more. There are little ones, as you can see here on this corner. The Minerva Nassau and the Aegean Odyssey.
Beautiful ships, beautiful. And so today there are 4. 2 days ago there were none. So there's good business in town because of these big 4 ships. And well, it's not without reason these ships came and visit Kusadasi, because Kusadasi really have much to offer. And well, this is the entrance of the I can't go any further because I don't have a ticket from one of these ships. And really fantastic, look at this beautiful place. And these guys are very smart, because when you go out of these ships you have to go through the shopping center. So the first thing what you see is the shopping center, so you have to spend money. That's the whole the reason of this beautiful shopping center. And that's a smart thought, because well, where tourists are only for one thing good, and that's for money. Okay. And these shops are not the same shops as in the center. These shops are the more luxury shops, the more expensive shops with really quality. Well, they have to look at this. Look at this. Unbelievable what this guy is selling. This is not for the normal guy. No, this is stuff for the. Look at this. Unbelievable. Beautiful. We don't see this in the Netherlands. In Rotterdam, we don't have these shops with all these beautiful stones and rings. So if you want to surprise your wife, well, in one of these shops you surely will manage to unbelievable, these are shops for kings. Look at this. I never see a shop, a jewelry shop like this in my hometown Rotterdam in the Netherlands. We don't have these kind of shops. And unbelievable. And there's another one. Well, everywhere you see beautiful, look at this, beautiful place. Nice shopping center, quality. They even have these turquoise hand woven carpet, as you can see, beautiful. The owner sitting there, he's waiting for his customers, and I'm sure he will have a good day today, because there are 4 ships out there. And he will for sure sell one of those carpets today. If he don't sell one of these cups, he's a bad salesman. It doesn't matter what you are looking for. If you have money in your pocket, when you return to that ship, your pocket will be less big than when you stepped out of that ship, okay? Because look at this. Beautiful. I don't know what they are, but well, they are sort of reminders. You visit this place, and it's always nice to have a reminder when you visit one of these places. Look at this, unbelievable, beautiful. I never saw a shop like this in the Netherlands, never. But all these beautiful artifacts, and of course they are not real artifacts, but if you put one of these things in your house, it will be the middle point of your house. Believe me, this is fantastic. So I'm just outside the port now, and these are the first shops you see when you go out of the port. And as you can see, one woman there is making someone hand-waved carpet. And 2 days ago she was not there. 2 days ago she was not there. She's only there for the show to give the tourist the feeling that all these carpets are handmade, and that's a very smart thing. Look at this beautiful square just behind the cruise ships. As you can see, the big cruise ships is just behind this square, and everything is made for these cruise tourists. And here you can have your dinner if you are interested in Turkish dish. And if I turn my camera away, you can see this beautiful street. I was here yesterday also, and you have this beautiful restaurant in an old fortress. Beautiful. Just a beautiful place to be, Kusadasi. I believe 1 week is not enough. You need minimum 2 weeks to see everything. And here we have it again, the sound of the mosque, the everyday returning sound. And well, it's a sort of relaxing sound. 2 days ago I was here in this beautiful place, Han, the famous Han, you can see it over there. And these guys have live music every evening. It's just 15 meters from my hotel. So I was here 2 days ago and I didn't know the name of the singer, the female singer. And as you can see on that statue over there, her name is Özlem. And she's a beautiful woman with a beautiful voice. And tonight the waiter told me there's another singer upstairs. I didn't know they have an upstairs. And well, if you like live music, classical live music, this is the place to be. Very beautiful sound, nice atmosphere, very close to Hotel de Ries, just 50 meters away in front of the boulevard, if you can see. And well, they deserve fish dishes, as you can see. They have all kind of fish. Let me go inside and look at this, because Kusadasi is famous of his fish dishes. And this is one of the restaurants in the middle of the center where you can eat the whole year, the whole season, beautiful fish, nice fish. It's the specialty. And here we have the place where I filmed yesterday this beautiful songs. Well, look at this, and I already filmed this, and I just asked the driver, I don't know how you have to call him, I call him driver, what is exactly the meaning of this carriage? And he told me, explained me, it only cost you 25 lire, and that's very little. 25 lire is 10 euro, and for this 10 euro, he drives you all the way up to the fort. And the fort is very far away, and it is for 2 big persons or for 4 smaller persons. Yes. And unbelievable. And it is worth the 10 euro, because look at this. Where you can find a nice romantic drive like this for 10 euro. And they stop right in front of my hotel, Hotel de Ries. And now I'm going to my hotel. I want to show you the swimming pool we have on top of this hotel. And I didn't saw that before, so for me it's also new. So I go now into the hotel. And so don't forget, when you are here and you need a romantic drive, just take this carriage for 25 lire. This guy brings you, well, to the fortress, he called it castle, and he brings you up to that castle and back for only 25 lire. Okay, thank you. What's your name?
What is your name, Nico?
My name is Andrew.
My
and
name is Nico. Nice to meet you.
Thanks to nice cooperate to on my movie, and a good business for you.
Thank you, my friend.
Bye bye. I am on the upper level of this Hotel de Ries, and these guys actually have a swimming pool on top of this hotel. Really, look at this. 2 ladies, English ladies, I just talked with them, are playing cards, not for money, just for fun, okay? And okay, I'm just walking, as you can see. This is the back side of the hotel. And here we have the stairs. Swimming pool. Okay, I take the stairs. Let me see what is this swimming pool all about. Okay, people sitting in. And here you can see this swimming pool, beautiful. And the view from this swimming pool, unbelievable. And from here you can see these, look at this. I want to swim, I go back to my room. I will put my swimming trousers and will go in this water. It looks so fantastic. And from this side, you can see the, look at them, the beautiful cruise ships, look at them. Look at the view, look at the view you have from this hotel, unbelievable. Isn't this something? And I am already here for 4 days, and it's the first time I'm on this rooftop. And why I didn't came here before, I don't know. There were plenty more things to do in Kusadasi. But today I thought, okay, why not give it a try? Why not see what's happening upstairs on this roof terrace from the Hotel de Ries? Beautiful view, look at this. You don't need beach when you have a hotel like this. A new day and a new cruise ships on the docks of Kusadasi. Look at this fantastic looking cruise ship. Very big. Norwegian Spirit. And today is, as you can see, again a cloudy day, but the sun is shining, and I hope it will stay like this, because yesterday evening it was only rain. I just had my first dentist job, and let me tell you something about the dentist here. Kusadasi is filled with dentists, over 100 dentists, and that's because a lot of foreigners come to Kusadasi to their dents. And it's way cheaper than in the Netherlands. I think it's about 1/3 to 25% of the price so you pay in Holland. And so a lot of people from the Netherlands, and I just met a woman from Ireland. She told me that the job she needed, an older woman that was, she needed to complete her full mouth. In Ireland it would cost 50,000 euro, and here in Kusadasi she only paid 15,000 euro. So that's a profit from 35,000 euro, and that's a brand new big car. So I can understand people, I'm one of them. I came to Kusadasi. Part of my journey was through my dents, and because it's way cheaper. In fact, I have a free holiday. So I had this treatment this morning, and I was very satisfied. And Tuesday they're gonna finish my job. In the time being, I will relax here a little bit more on the beach side, on the shore side from Kusadasi. And well, I inform you if there will come more of those nice big cruise ships like the Norwegian Spirit. So we are here in the Marina Bay for all the yachts, and this is on the left side of my hotel. As you can see, you can walk. They put some nice trees here, very nice. Some cactuses on this side. And as you can see, the marina. If I'm on top, I will zoom in on these nice yachts. Beautiful yachts. Look at this. I'm almost on top of this little hill they built. And underneath this hill, there are, well, shops. Look at this beautiful. Well, this is really a place to see. And from here I can see my hotel. I will zoom in on my hotel. Look at this. You see my hotel here? Really, this hotel is in the middle of everywhere. Unbelievable. I really choose the right hotel. I didn't make a mistake this time. I just came on my balcony and just take a bath, and I see the guy who catched the big fish yesterday. I think he do it again, and I zoom in. I'm not there at the moment, so I put it on maximum zoom. Well, as you can see, he have a fish in his hands. It's not that very big, but it's big enough. It's big enough. So happy I was on time on my balcony to film this for you. It's not that big as the fish he had before, and from this distance I can't see what kind of fish it is. My zoom is 20 times, but it's not that strong. If it was a 30 times zoom, I could completely zoom in on the fish. But he is happy. It's a good catch. Well, as you can see, this is the route these cruise ships make.
Kusadasi.
Kusadasi to Samos, to Mykonos, to Santorini, Kos, and to Boutrum. Sunday today, and as you can see behind me, a new ship is coming in the harbor, new cruise ship, and oh, lovely girls here. These girls passing by really distract me. And anyway, the new ship is coming, and well, let me show you what's in the harbor now. Big ship, unbelievable. P&O cruises, and one behind it, as you can see, I can't read what kind of ship it is, but the next one is already coming in. Look at that. Let me zoom in. Many cruise ships doing Kusadasi because of its many shops, and today the weather is very nice. It's cloudy. It's cloudy. It's early in the afternoon at the moment. I just came from my hotel room. It's my, well, I leave tomorrow. And well, again, there are new cruise ships behind me, as you can see. And every day, two, three, sometimes four new cruise ships arrive in Kusadasi. That means life is here the whole time. Even in, well, in a time like this, in October, most cities, most tourist places, they are empty. But Kusadasi is still full because of these beautiful cruise ships. Look at this, four of them. Today there are four very big cruise ships, unbelievable. And these ships leave today, and tomorrow new ships arrive. I'm going now to the Lady Beach. It's empty, probably it's empty because it's not beach weather. But I will take the bus because I heard it's 1 hour walking, and I'm a little bit lazy to walk for 1 hour, so I will take a bus, and I come back when I arrive there, and I will film the Lady Beach for you, so you can see what this Lady Beach is all about. I'm sitting now in the Dolbush, and as you can see, this is the port, the entrance of the port, and well, I'm just gonna show you the complete route to the Ladies Beach. Look at these big ships, yes. The bus is a little bit shaky, but we can film. Beautiful, these ships. And in a few seconds we will pass this fortress I was a few days ago. You can see it from here. Thank you.
first place. Look at this, downstairs. Beautiful houses, beautiful beach. Everybody who visit Kusadasi to take the Dolbus. It's very cheap, it's not very comfortable, but it brings you to your place very fast. You don't have to wait more than 5 minutes for the next bus, so ladies' beach, no.
No, we're there then.
The next one.
Another, yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Just down the bottom, you see the beach.
Thank you. Oh, this English woman say the next stop is ladies' beach. I'm so curious. I hardly can't wait to film this for you guys. The closer we get, the more beautiful the place is becoming. I think we are here, I'm not sure. Because I'm here new, so like you guys, I don't. Oh, we are here. We are here.
Hello.
Ladies' beach, thank you. Well, here we are. So I came from there, walked the stairs. First thing I noticed was this sewer pipe. And this sewer pipe just go in the sea, so I'm not sure if the water is clean, if you can swim here. But look at the weather. Sun is shining. The end of October, beautiful weather. And there are actual people on the beach. I thought I would saw an empty beach, but there are people. And look at these palm trees. All in a line. Beautiful. Well, this is the famous Lady Beach from Kusadasi. Just, well, 5 minutes drive with the Dolbus. And look at these nice hotels. But I advise everybody who came out of the season like now not to book a hotel near this Lady Beach. You better can book a hotel close to the center where my hotel is. Because, well, there's only beach here. And let's be honest, how many days in the end of October you can spend on the beach? But it looks nice. I don't see they make any, well, the sand is brown. It's not really, well, it started here. I just on the beginning of the beach, as you can see, and people laying here on the beach. Beautiful place to be. Only 5 minutes drive from the Ritz Hotel,
from the center, and the bus only costed me 2 lire 15. That's not even 1 euro. So for this 1 euro, or 80 cents to be exactly, you are in the ladies' beach. Look at these big hotels on the end. Let me zoom in. Big hotels. Well, actually, I expected more from this beach. Really, I thought it was wider. I thought the sand was more wider, this brown sand as you can see. Well, maybe in summer when it is very hot, it will have another color. Well, here I am in the middle of this beach, exactly in the middle. I came from that direction and I walk until here. And there's the end, as you can see. And here we have this stair. This stair bringing you to the beach. A wooden stair, nice. And well, I have a much better view from over here. This beautiful palm tree, just next to the stair. And let me go a few steps down, so you can see the view you have from this side. Beautiful. It's a nice place. Maybe tomorrow I just wear my swimming trouser, and well, if it is weather like this, I might come over here to take a little bit sun and to take a dive in the water. Why not? Beautiful. And I think this is the local most busiest restaurant in town, because a lot of people here drinking their coffee, eating their ice, cheeseburger sandwiches. These guys sell everything. Beach places, beach restaurant, they have double prices everywhere on the world. In the Netherlands, in England, in America, beach restaurants have double prices than you pay in the city. And well, look at these prices. You can't even buy a Big Mac for a complete meal in this place. Unbelievable. Well, keep in mind that when you came back from Kusadasi, you will be very fat because you eat so much, because these things are so cheap, you just can't stop eating. And who said the turkey was not modern? Look at this. Look at what these guys sell. Unbelievable. So this is 2-in-1. Dildo and bottle opener. This is funny. And they even have the black model. Hell, all colors available, and only for 10 lire. This is about 3 euro. Unbelievable. Dildo and bottle opener for 10 lire. This is cheap. So I'm now in the end of the beach, and as you can see, beautiful buildings against the rocks. I think they are hotels. Yes, Hotel Marti. Let me zoom in. Hotel Marti. And another one. I can't read it, but it's looking very nice. Very nice view over the ocean. Maybe I will return one day when it is season time, because really, this place, I start loving this place after a few days. I'm here now almost a week, and the longer I'm here, the more I'm gonna love this place. Really beautiful.
Well, this was my Lady Beach adventure, and I'm already going back. I'm sitting in the Dolbus back to town. They built some new houses here, very nice houses. Look at this. A lot of them are still empty, waiting for a new owner. And but for now, I'm sitting in this cozy bus. And I think I will be in Kusadasi Center in 3-4 minutes. This bus goes very fast. I think middle in the season these buses are always full. But now it's just quiet in Kusadasi and everything looks empty. So even this hotel, look at this. No cars, no people, no folks. Look at this, unbelievable. I think this part is the highlight of this small tour from the Kusadasi Dolbus. Look at these ships, beautiful. from sight of them. One even bigger than the other. Four in a row. Here you can see them all. Unbelievable. There's police everywhere, not that much, but I feel pretty safe here in Kusadasi. There are a lot of places in the world where you actually can't leave your hotel. It's just too unsafe to leave your hotel. But in Kusadasi, well, all my journeys to Turkey so far, I was never afraid. It's pretty safe in Turkey because you don't see much police. But there is a lot of police, and they just like normal people, but you don't see them. So criminals just don't have any chance.
So let me tell you why I took my lunches. Every day, same place. I go to this place, just 50 meters away from my hotel. I enter this, well, it's a dinner place. And I always take the same thing. That's a strange thing of me. When I like something, I start repeating this dish because I know what it is. I don't take a risk with any other dish. And this is what I take. Let me zoom in. This is the waiter. He always is making this very good for me. Yes, and this is the thing, the upper one. As you can see, 6 lira. And 6 lira, let me tell you something about how much that is in euro. 6 lira is about 2.50 euro. So and this is the thing, unbelievable. Look at this, big. You are really filled up with this thing. You can eat this like a dinner. This big is it. That's why I get fat. Every time when I come back from Turkey, I get fat. Because I eat so much, because the food is so delicious here. But I'm gonna eat now because I'm very hungry. I'm now on the roof terrace from Hotel de Ritzi, and as you can see, this beautiful pool. Nobody's swimming. I think the water is very cold, but I'm gonna give it a try. I'm gonna actually swim today because I'm here to swim and I don't mind if the water is too cold. Look at the sun, beautiful sun. And from here you can see all these cruise ships and beautiful view from this hotel roof terrace. And I'm alone, two guys over there sitting or lying, and they are not swimming, so I'm the only one who will swim today. I think in the main season this roof terrace will be full because it's very nice with a beautiful view. Hotel de Ritzi. Well, today is almost my last day on my holiday in Kusadasi. And the main event I was in Kusadasi was of the dentist. And now I am back in the dentist because I thought I needed more preparation in my mouth. But I was lucky. I needed only two new crowns. And to be honest, that means that my holiday was free because the two crowns, costed me in Kusadasi with Dr. Pinar only 500 euro. Also cleaning, everything together 500 euro. In the Netherlands, it would set me back about 1300 euro. That means my holiday is free and I have a little bit money left to buy some nice clothes, well, nice souvenirs, and to enjoy my holiday, make it complete. And, well, as you can see, I'm on the balcony of the doctor, the day doctor, because I was a little bit too late. And as you can see, I'm here. The doctor is very close to my hotel, just 10 minutes walking. And I have my breakfast. Of course, after the breakfast, before you go to the dentist, don't forget to clean your teeth. The dentist will want to see that breakfast rest in your mouth when she treats you. So I had to go back to my apartment and I forget to shave myself, because when I go to a dentist, I always want to be neat. So that's why I'm a little bit late, 10 minutes late, but I don't think she would be upset. And well, I will tell you more later about this cheap dentist traveling to Kusadasi. There are over 100 dentists here only in Kusadasi because of the price. But my dentist, I know from my dentist that she is good, because my brother went first and he was very happy, so I choose her. And I don't know about the other doctors. I know from this dentist she is good. Dr. Pinar, she is, well, if you Google Pinar, Kusadasi, Dr. Pinar, you will find her. I give you this very good tip because he's one of the best, okay? I go back in the waiting room because I think my turn is almost there to finish my workout. So I will be happy when it gets a smile. Today I'm standing just in front of this carpet shop. And one of the workers explained me that these carpets are handmade. And this is a very big shop. Just in front of the, as you can see, in front of the cruise ships. And today is a party. I will explain later what the party is about. It's a national, well, I will explain later. But today, I'm gonna show you inside. He's going to explain me that all these carpets are really handmade. It's no joke. Not fabric carpets, handmade carpets. And the most beautiful you can find in this shop. In this shop in Kusadasi. One of the biggest shops in Kusadasi. Handmade, really. Okay. Thank you.
Yok.
Beautiful shop, look at this. All these carpets. And they don't only sell carpets, they only also sell jewelry. So
you make also silk for concealed.
Look at this! They make silk carpets, unbelievable. Look at these machines. Well, it's worth visit this place if you need a nice carpet. I think this is the best place. I've been in several carpet stores, but none of them was like this. None of them. Look at this, unbelievable. It's like a museum. It's like a museum, beautiful. And unbelievable, this. I didn't expect. And it is really handmade. I go upstairs now because he told me upstairs are the carpets.
You like that? You like that? Here. You can't see. I'll talk to you very good.
Beautiful, look at this. This door is big.
You make it a silk carpet.
This door is very big. And here a woman is making a silk carpet. This is the finest quality you can find all over the world. There is no better quality than a silk handmade carpet. I don't want to talk too loud because I don't want to make this woman to disturb her job, because it's a very difficult job and a slow process. It takes many hours to finish this carpet, and well, these Turkish women are specialists. And if you see how beautiful these carpets are,
double nuts,
especially
double nuts.
They are double nuts.
The other countries they use single nuts.
The other countries use single knobs, he explained, and in Turkey,
make it with double knobs.
And that means it's more stronger. It's more stronger. Okay. Well, unbelievable. I learned something new here today. I didn't knew that. And well, this was all from this beautiful shop. And I hope when you visit Kusadasi and you need a new carpet, just visit this shop. You will be impressed. Because what I saw today, I visit other shops in Turkey, in Kusadasi, on my trip here. But this shop really, well, it's not a shop, it's a big store. 3 stories, 4 stories high. And look at this. He just sell this carpet to a customer. And
they make it like that.
Look at this, is the storage room. And
they make it like
that. Unbelievable. Look what these guys have. This is worth millions. They have so many carpets finished. Unbelievable. Look at this. I had a Chinese carpet once, and believe me, this quality is much better than the Chinese quality I see now. Because look at this quality, and this is the back side of the carpet. So you can see how fine the structure is. Let me zoom in. The structure is very fine. Unbelievable. This is, and I thought it was fabric. I thought it was all fabric clothes, but these carpets are handmade, and you can see that. Really, I am surprised.
He is Burhan,
nice to meet you. I'm and
carpets open.
He make it carpets open.
Yes.
And I'm Andrew from the Netherlands. Hello. And I'm filming this shop, this quality carpets, just for my viewers, because I have a lot of viewers. Okay. Look at this. This is a small carpet. It is shiny. I think it's silk because
no,
it is.
It's wool.
It's wool.
This very is good wool quality. Shining like a silk.
Okay. This
from
is
from the neck here.
Okay. You heard. He just explained us what it is, and well, it's just beautiful. And
it is natural, but
it's unbelievable what I see here. This I really didn't expect.
This carpet is undyed, the natural color from the sheep.
The natural color from the sheep, he explained me.
Undyed.
Look at this.
Brown beige.
Let me. This is unbelievable. So this is not with farbed color. This is the original color from the sheep.
Colors from the sheep, yes.
The original colors from the sheep. Mm-hmm. So they are normal carpets. They are colored. They are colored in the factory, but this is not colored. This is the original color from the sheep. I never heard of that. I learned new things, and my viewers also. So you have to visit this shop. Is that a carpet? No, that's not a carpet.
No, this is the other one is carpet. This is not carpet. This is Ottoman.
This Ottoman, this was the big emperor, but he was defeated. I know my history. He was defeated by these guys, the Huns. He was defeated by the Huns. That's correct. He was by the big army from the Huns, because I know my history. And these are carpets. Okay, this is unbelievable. This is this is a Catholic picture. In a Muslim country, and it's very nice, beautiful.
Look at here, this Last Supper.
This is the Last Supper from Leonardo da Vinci, and they made this because this is the most famous, one of the most famous paintings from Leonardo da Vinci, the Last Supper, and it is made on this. Well, believe me, I like more the carpet than the original painting, because look at this, it looks like a real painting. Look at beautiful. As you know, the original painting from Leonardo da Vinci is already faded away. The colors are not that good anymore from all these years. But this carpet, the legs from the tables are exactly the same as from the painting. Look at this. Because I know this painting very good. I studied this painting. Do you also have the Mona Lisa?
Mona Lisa? No.
Because. Okay, this is a fortress, black and white, beautiful paint. Well, they are carpets, but they look like paintings, and I think they have more value than paintings.
Look at the horns and Istanbul.
This is Istanbul. Okay, in this time the name was Constantinople. When this
old name.
Or Constantinople. When this paint. This is a carpet from a painting. Yeah. The original was a painting. Okay. When this painting was made, the name from Istanbul was Constantinople, and we all know the story of Constantinople. And well, this was the old Istanbul. Look at this beautiful detail. This is fantastic, really. Unbelievable, this quality. What this guy sells here, I never saw in the Netherlands. Unbelievable, look at this. So small, so detailed. In this small painting, or yeah, I call it painting, but it is a carpet. They are carpets.
Handmade carpets.
I don't gonna ask for prices, because if you wanna find out what the price are, you have to visit this shop, yeah. But bring a big wallet with you, because I believe this carpet.
Different quality, different prices. Right?
Yes. Okay, he explained me different qualities, different prices, and that's normal. Beautiful.
Yeah.
And the name of the shop is Topkapi. The name of the shop is Topkapi. Look at this. When you visit Kusadasi, just come to the shop, Topaki. Well, as you see, today is a big celebration day. It is the 150 years celebration from, well, a republic. So, and 150 years, and they celebrate it big. Tonight there is music on the square. I will film that later in the evening. And today, look at this. Beautiful. A lot of police on this beautiful square just in front of the cruise ships. And of course, they made some flowers here. I'll zoom in. So the festivities start today, and it will be the whole day. I won't film this too long, because this is not happening every time. This is just once in many years. And I was just lucky to be here on this 150 years anniversary from this republic, this young republic, 150 years old. They put flags above it, as you can see. And well, the carpet store also made some celebration. This flag is normally not in front of the carpet store, but today they put it extra to celebrate this 150 years Republic anniversary, this big carpet store, the best in Kusadasi. Look at this cruise ship. The two anchor holes, they are looking like a shark watching you. Beautiful built cruise ship. It just arrived. I saw it arrive this morning. I was in the breakfast room and I saw this ship coming in, and the first thing I saw was this, well, it looks like a shark looking you in the eyes, the two anchor holes. Beautiful. Let me zoom in. So this is my last day in Kusadasi, my 8 days visit in Turkey. It was my first time in Kusadasi. All the times before I went to Bodrum, Gumbet, I loved that place very much, but all the times it was hot in the summertime. It's end of October now, and well, I expected better weather, but okay, I have 2 days of rain, 6 days of nice weather, and really enjoyed this time. I really think these 8 days are too short for this holiday to see Kusadasi, because Kusadasi is very big. I showed you the cruise ships, I showed you the ladies' beach, I showed you this expensive carpet store, how they make these handmade carpets. And really, that carpet store is a visit, it's worth a visit. If you ever are in Kusadasi, you have to visit the carpet store. The Ritchie Hotel, well, it was fantastic, the food was fantastic, the people who worked there was fantastic, and I enjoyed the cafe Han with a double N. It's over there. And I showed you how I had my holiday was completely free, and I showed you how I did it. I went to the dentist and I saved about 750 euro with the visit to the dentist. And with that 750 euro, I paid my holiday, I paid my clothes, I bought some clothes here, very cheap, I bought t-shirts here, everything, and I still have money left. So when I would do my dance in Holland, I could not have made this holiday. So think before you do something. Always think before you do something. I thought right, because I had a free holiday, perfect dentist job, and well, maybe tonight there is still a live show because of the 150 year celebration of the, well, the Republic of Turkey. And I will film that also, but for now I say, well, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe on my channel. Well, for now I say, from Turkey, bye-bye.